Good day, my friends. Billy here, and I'm so excited to announce my book. It's finally about to come out very soon to a bookstore, to the internet, to the world, and I'm just so excited because it's been a labor of love. It's been an inspiration of mine. It's a calling of mine. I mean, I didn't go to college. I don't have a degree in really anything but my life's results, and this is my ultimate dharma, my purpose. I feel guided to have created this book for you, and it's my great honor to bring it to the world. So it's coming out very soon, but this is my announcement. I just want everyone to know about it, The Now-IST, and the subtitle is Finding the Signs to Your Ultimate Desires in No Time. And it teaches you how to use your present moment awareness along with your imagination and giving to attract abundance in your life. And it's a teaching, it's also a spiritual memoir about my life and about how I found the now and how I became a Now-IST and how I really would like you to join me in that journey of being in the present moment, of living out of time and out of the stress and the schedule and the worrying of the daily life that we all go through. Our daily life tends to get caught up in the minutiae of doing, and this current of life pulls you along without awareness. And this book, The Now-IST, teaches you how to have that awareness and how to get more connected to the present moment. It's very common for people to call it mindfulness, awarefulness, or present moment thinking. Well, The Now-IST is really a teaching about that. And it's my great honor to do this for you and to present this to you. I will tell you a little later about how to get this book for free. So stay tuned. Have you ever had the challenge of being caught up in stress and in a moment where your life seems to be collapsing, or the present moment seems to be full of stress or full of unconditional things that you can't control, where the kids or your work or a relationship or someone cuts you off at the freeway, or your finances aren't where they want to be, or your physicality, your emotions, your health isn't where you want it to be? Well, I've had that challenge too. And in my life, I've gone through many, many times where I was caught up in the world, and I was caught up in time, and I was caught up in the doing of the world. And it's kind of corny when people say we are human beings, not human doings, but I was that human doing. This book is largely part of my journey of getting out of the world. And I know most of my friends and my family, the people that I have served and been inspired to teach, have had that same problem in their life. And they're caught up in the minutiae of the world, in the chronological linear time of this life. And my job and my purpose and my great dharma is to help you get out of that time. I can think of a time in my life where I struggled with success and I struggled with failure. I was afraid of success and I feared failure so much that it almost cost me my life. I think of a time when I was in high school and I was a track star, and there was a lot riding on my career as a track athlete, as a superstar. It was my junior year in high school and I was all set to win the state championship. I placed second that year up in Washington in Tacoma. Got to the next year, and it was my senior year, I was supposed to win, because that previous year, the past, had set me up for the future, and I was afraid of that success. I was afraid of not completing that success, letting my family down, letting my friends down, letting the potential college scholarship that was on its way down, like it was not gonna happen if I didn't win. A lot was riding on that. But previous to that event, the prior 2 months from my state track meet my senior year, I was entered another track meet. And the bar was set at 15 feet, and I was set to clear it. And I ran up as fast as I could, I planted my pole, I inverted upside down and backwards, and bam, my pole snaps, I hit the back of my head on the box, and this arm was shredded and bleeding. And I'm laying on the track thinking, I almost died, and I'm really freaked out, and what happened? Just 2 months later, I had to compete in the state track meet. And there I go, on that same runway, with the pole, running down and running right through the mat. It's called a scratch, it's a no attempt. You get 3 attempts. I scratched the second attempt and the third attempt. I ran off that mat and I sat in a dirty parking lot in Tacoma, Washington under a street light. And I sat there and I cried for 4 hours with my head in my hands, thinking I was a failure and not knowing what I was gonna do. And from that moment, I decided that I needed help. So I was looking for other teachers, for spiritual help teachers, for gurus, for self-help masters to help me get out of my state of being, to help me get out of failure. I had a fear of success, obviously, because my fear was if I don't win my state meet my senior year, then I was going to be a loser and I would fail. And now ultimately that's what happened. Because of that traumatic event I lived in my past, and that moment that I had to change my stars, to compete at a higher level, was gone, and I failed. But then I realized that failure is only an opportunity. You don't really create failure. I mean, you can be a failure, you can, you know, be judged by the world as a failure, but the reality is you've only created a result. You produced a result. If I jumped and I cleared a height, you know, without it being success, ultimately it comes down to what I'm going to do in that moment that makes my life different, what makes my life progress in a better fashion or in a place where I'm not worried about the future so much or concerned about the past. I've learned about the present moment. I didn't know it at the time, but that moment was like a red herring. It was an opportunity to realize that was one of the lowest points of my entire life, and I let everybody down. But I started to follow self-help gurus, people, spiritual teachers, people that had figured out how to get out of this life and out of this time and out of the chronological past and future of success and failure and what the Joneses think and how to live up to other people's expectation. So as I drank deeply of these books, I figured out how to get out of that struggle and how to get out of that negative focus, that negative mindset. So my story ultimately came to a solution in a one-syllable word, N-O-W. What does that spell? Now, what's that spell backwards? One. When you're in the now, you have won. You've won your presence back. The now doesn't live in time. The now only lives in the present moment. And that's what this book is about. It teaches you how to live in the present moment, how to get out of time, how to take your power back by focusing on this present moment. And from that, there's a teaching and a process that this book teaches you how to get out of that, get out of the time, and find out the place in this moment that gives you the greatest power, and that is the now. And I've become a nowist, and it's my great honor to bring it to you. And the book is coming very, very soon. And it's my honor to be of service to you. Stay tuned, and you can find out in the next video how to get this book for free. Wishing you all the blessed.